Syphilis. Syphilis is a sexually transmitted infection, STI, caused by the Spirochetra bone pallidum, a bacterial species. Syphilis has been a recognized clinical entity for many centuries, with the first recorded case described in 1494 among soldiers. Like tuberculosis, syphilis has been nicknamed the Great Imitator because the clinical manifestations of late-stage syphilis are protean. While syphilis is a treatable infection, long-standing unrecognized infection can have systemic implications and can even result in death. Maintaining a high index of suspicion, and testing for syphilis where clinically appropriate, can prevent dire long-term consequences. Syphilis is transmitted by individuals in the primary or secondary stages of infection. It enters the body of a new host through microscopic skin or mucous membrane abrasions. Lesions of primary and secondary syphilis, including chancres and Cantaloma lata, are very infectious, and approximately 66% of exposed primary contacts will become infected. Modes of transmission include close personal contact, sexual contact, kissing, or other close contact with mucocutaneous lesions, blood transfusions, accidental bacterial inoculation, and transplacental passage because T. pallidum is very susceptible to environmental insults such as drying, heat, and disinfectants. It has a very low survival rate outside the human body and does not persist on foments. Syphilis facilitates HIV transmission. In an HIV-infected individual, syphilis breaches mucosal barriers and thus increases HIV shedding. In an HIV-susceptible individual, syphilis induces a breach in the mucosal barrier and also recruits HIV-susceptible cells to the area of inflammation. Conversely, HIV is thought to alter the natural history of syphilis. In particular, HIV-positive patients may evince atypical clinical manifestations of syphilis and may experience a more rapid course of progression to later stages of the disease, including neurosyphilis. However, the degree to which HIV affects the clinical course of syphilis is still hotly debated. Herpes simplex or HSV2 is extremely common in the United States. One in four persons over the age of 30 is estimated to be infected with HSV2, but most remain unaware of their infection. HSV1 is a similar virus which mostly causes oral cold sores or fever blisters, but is said to be the cause of 20% of genital herpes cases because it can be transmitted by oral to genital contact. According to the Center for Disease Control, CDC, 45 million Americans from ages 12 and up have experienced a genital HSV infection. Genital herpes is more common in women, 1 out of 4 women, than in men, approximately 1 out of 8. The virus can be transmitted through sexual contact with someone infected with herpes even if they have no symptoms at the time of sexual contact. Symptoms and signs of infection. Symptoms of herpes simplex are usually more severe and occur more frequently than HSV1. The first outbreak, which usually occurs 2 weeks after infection, for either virus is commonly more noticeable and painful than subsequent outbreaks and includes a cluster of lesions that cause a burning sensation. After the lesions appear, the patient can expect vesicles to appear, which cause uncomfortable sensation while walking and urinating. The vesicles contain infectious fluids and usually heal in a couple of weeks. Those who are infected can expect several outbreaks within the first year of transmission. In subsequent years, outbreaks are likely to decrease in frequency. HSV eventually goes into lifelong latent state in the body's nerve cells. Approximately 90% of those infected with HSV2 and 50% of those infected with HSV1 experience recurrences. The herpes simplex virus can also cause potentially fatal infections in babies, especially if a woman contracts the virus in the late stages of pregnancy, because this increases the likelihood of transmission of the virus from the mother to the baby. If a mother is experiencing an outbreak during childbirth, a cesarean delivery is required. Also, it is now thought that HSV may cause someone to become more susceptible to HIV, the virus that causes AIDS, and cause people already infected with HIV to become more infectious. Treatments, options, and prevention. There is no cure for HSV 2 or 1. Antiviral drugs can be prescribed by doctors to help reduce the frequency and severity of outbreaks of those infected. The three most popular antiviral treatments are acyclovir, Zovirax, famciclovir, Famvir, and valacyclovir, Valtrex. There are also three types of antiviral therapies that your doctor may recommend: initial treatment, intermittent treatment, and suppressive treatment. Initial treatment is meant to reduce the severity of the first outbreak. During intermittent treatment, a doctor will prescribe you antivirals to have just in case you have a flaring of symptoms. Suppressive treatment is meant for those who experience frequent outbreaks. Antivirals are taken every day to suppress the outbreaks and can do so by 70% to 80%. There are only a few ways to prevent contracting HSV2 or 1. The first is to completely abstain from sexual intercourse. Other precautions include limiting the amount of your sexual partners, ideally to one person who has been tested and known to not be infected with HSV. Also, wearing a condom during sex, but please note that this might not be a complete safeguard against infection because outbreaks can occur on the external genitalia of women, or at the base of the penis in men. Gonorrhea. Gonorrhea is the second most common sexual transmitted disease. This disease targets sexually active people, and in most cases those who are infected don't even have symptoms. The symptoms for men and women have some similarities and differences, but in both cases if left untreated this can lead to infertility. If symptoms do arise, then it is best to avoid sex and go to a doctor. Unfortunately, the bacterium that causes gonorrhea, Neisseria gonorrhoeae, develops resistance for the antibiotic very quickly. Currently there are drugs that are being used to cure gonorrhea, but there are signs of resistance. To avoid getting gonorrhea, it is best to avoid all sexual contact. Some men who do have gonorrhea don't have any signs at all. For those who do have signs, these appear 2 to 5 days after they have been infected, but in some cases it can take up to 30 days for symptoms to appear. The symptoms that men usually undergo are a burning sensation while urinating, or a white, yellow or green discharge from the penis. In some cases, men who have gonorrhea get painful or swollen testicles. If this infection is not treated in men, then this could lead to epididymitis, which is a painful condition of the ducts attached to the testicles that may lead to infertility if left untreated. For women who are infected with gonorrhea, most of the time they have no symptoms. But when they do have symptoms, they are often mild, and sometimes are mistaken for a bladder or vaginal infection. Symptoms include painful or burning sensation when urinating, increased vaginal discharge, or vaginal bleeding between periods. If left untreated, women with gonorrhea can develop pelvic inflammatory disease. Each year in the U.S. about 1 million women develop PID. The symptoms of PID can be mild or quite severe. Symptoms include abdominal pain and fever, internal abscesses, pus-filled pockets that are hard to cure, and chronic pelvic pain. PID can damage the fallopian tubes enough to cause infertility. In both men and women, symptoms of rectal infection include discharge, anal edging, soreness, bleeding, or painful bowel movements. Infections in the throat can cause a sore throat, but usually those who are infected in this area have no symptoms at all. For both men and women, if gonorrhea is not treated, then it can spread to the blood or even the joints, this being life-threatening. Lastly, those with gonorrhea can become infected more easily with HIV. The surest way to avoid getting infected with gonorrhea or transmitting it is to not have sex at all, or to be in a long-term relationship with a partner who has been tested and is known to not have gonorrhea. Using latex condoms consistently can help reduce the risk of transmitting the disease. Any genital symptoms such as burning while urinating or an unusual rash should not be ignored, but a signal to stop having sex and notify a doctor as soon as possible. If a person has been diagnosed with gonorrhea, they should avoid having sex until they have completed their treatment for gonorrhea. Please subscribe to our channel and give this video thumbs up. Share this video with your friends on Facebook and Twitter. Thanks for watching.